Hello boys, welcome back to another session of video tutorials. And this session is meant for class 11th biology students, and this is for 22nd December 2020. And as all of us know, we are into quick revision and we are revising the entire syllabus after having completed normal video tutorials. And today, as part of that, we are dealing with chapter number 18, body fluids and circulation. And in this, as all of you know, we need to know what are the various fluids that flow in our body and how do they circulate, what do they circulate, what is the significance of the circulation, what happens if circulation doesn't take place in our body. So once we know what are all the materials that need to be circulated, for example, oxygen, take. If oxygen is not circulated, what happens? Cellular respiration will not take place. Cellular respiration doesn't take place, then what happens? No 36 ATPs will be released. When ATPs are not released, energy is not produced. When energy is not there, cell in gradual time dies. Cell dies, tissue dies. Tissue dies, organs die. Organs die, organ system and organism as a whole. That's why oxygen is a must. It is to be circulated. Along with oxygen, of course, glucose is a must. So without oxygen and glucose, there is no question of energy inside our body. So without energy, organism perishes. Hence, oxygen and glucose must get circulated in our body. And who will carry this? Some body fluids. And of course, you know, there are two fluids that flow in our body. One is the blood, all important blood, and second one is the lymph. So blood carries all these materials that we have been talking, that is oxygen, glucose. And we also know that at the end of respiration, a lot of carbon dioxide will be released, which is toxic. So carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, such gases cannot be afforded to stay inside our body for a long time because they are toxic. They need to be eliminated. And whenever we consume food, before it becomes glucose, other things also will be formed. Like for example, whenever we are eating or consuming proteins, proteinaceous diet of nowadays, it has become very fashion to talk about highly nutritious food. And whenever someone says highly nutritious food, they automatically refer to proteinaceous food. Of course, on positive side, yes, proteins are building materials. They build the body. They give a lot of muscles, okay, accepted. But what about the digestion of proteins, end product of digestion of proteins? Invariably, nitrogenous compounds. That is, the urea will be formed. So again, the uric acid has to be eliminated. The nitrogenous compounds have to be eliminated. We can't afford to keep them inside. So they have to be eliminated. So again, circulation helps in not only distributing the useful products to all the tissues, but also eliminating all the waste, dangerous, toxic substances from each cell of our body. That is the importance of body fluids and circulation. So let's go in details. Body fluids are the medium of transport of nutrients. Whatever we eat, basically nutrients, carbohydrates, fats, proteins, vitamins and minerals, and of course oxygen and other important substances in the body. So basically, body fluids, intracellular fluid. Intra means within, and extracellular fluid, outside the cell. So the intracellular is cytoplasm, fluid of the each cell. And extracellular fluid, it can be blood, it can be lymph, it can be cerebrospinal fluid, etc. So blood is the most commonly used body fluid in most of the higher organisms. Lymph is also transports certain substances like proteins and fats. So basically, there are two fluids that help us. One is the blood, another is the lymph. And all of you know that blood is a fluid connective tissue. It's a type of connective tissue. It's composed of fluid matrix, plasma, and the blood corpuscles. You know, there are three types of blood corpuscles: red blood corpuscle, white blood corpuscle, and platelets. So three. And it forms about 30-35% of extracellular fluid. It is slightly alkaline fluid having pH 7.4. and what are the components of it? So basically, blood has got plasma, a liquid part of it, and then formed elements, that is the erythrocytes, RBC, leukocytes, WBC, thrombocytes, platelets. And these three are the solid parts, and the liquid part is plasma, which is made up of water, proteins, and mineral ions. So blood is a mobile fluid connective tissue. It's composed of a fluid, the plasma, and the cells, which are called blood corpuscles. Plasma is slightly alkaline, non-living, intercellular substance that constitutes about 60% part of our blood. So 60% of the blood is plasma. It's pale yellow, but transparent and clear fluid. Water alone forms about 90-92% of the plasma. Plasma proteins constitute about 7-8% part of the plasma. These mainly include albumin, globulin, prothrombin, and fibrinogen. These are the proteins. Plasma without clotting factors is called serum. So again, I repeat, plasma without clotting factors is called serum. So that's about plasma, as we said just now. And continuing, it's a straw colored viscous fluid which constitutes about 55%, we said 60%. It consists of 90-92% water, 6-8% proteins, of course we named it, and glucose will be there, amino acids will be there, small amount of minerals like sodium, calcium, chloride ions will be there. Next, the solid materials that will be present in the blood is erythrocytes, leukocytes, and platelets are collectively called formed elements. Erythrocytes are most abundant cells in human body. Total blood count of RBC is 5 to 5.5 million, which is slightly less in females due to menstruation. It is formed in bone marrow. This is important. Where is the location or preparation site of erythrocytes? It's the bone marrow. And nucleus is absent, enucleated cells. Okay, nucleus is absent in mammalian RBCs having biconcave shape. So every 100 ml of blood contain 12-16 grams. Now this is most important. Often you must check your hemoglobin. How much? If it is below this, you are anemic. So just once in a while have the check of hemoglobin. And once, if someone is anemic, you become weak, okay, and lot of sweating will be there, and you are not interested in anything, you are not able to focus, all these factors will be there. Hence, it is better to check once in a while, once worn hemoglobin in the blood. They have a lifespan of, again, this neat exam question, RBC's lifespan, 120 days, means, is it 4 months? We can say 4 months, 4 into 30. They are destroyed in spleen. Again, neat question. Is that's why spleen is called graveyard of RBCs. Okay, these are all what we talked about, erythrocytes. So erythrocytes, leukocytes, and platelets are collectively called formed elements. Erythrocytes or RBCs have red colored iron containing complex protein called hemoglobin. Leukocytes, also known as white blood cells, so leukocytes are white blood cells, are colorless due to absence of hemoglobin. 6,000 to 8,000 of WBC are present in each ml of blood. See the numbers, so heavy there. And they are our soldiers, as all of you know. And there are varieties of WBCs. Okay, what are those? The WBCs are granulocytes, agranulocytes. What do you mean by that? Granulocytes. Granulocytes are neutrophils, eosinophils, okay, and basophils. As you are seeing, eosinophils, basophils, neutrophils, granulocytes. And agranulocytes are lymphocytes and monocytes. Neutrophils are the most abundant cells. So these are the most abundant cells, neutrophils. About 60 to 65%, okay, of the total WBC are neutrophils. Neutrophils are monocytes, 6 to 8%, are phagocytic cells that destroy foreign organisms entering the body. That's why they are our soldiers. Basophils, something like 0 to 1%, secrete histamine, serotonin, heparin, and are involved in inflammatory reactions. Okay, basophils. And eosinophils, 2 to 3%, resist infections and are also associated with allergic reactions. There's something called eosinophilia associated with. Normally, it should be 2 to 3% in some people because of infection or hypersensitiveness. The eosinophils number go up, something like 8 to 10%. Then there will be dry cough and chest pain. A continuous cough will be there. That's eosinophilia. Okay, so one must be careful about that. Then lymphocytes. Lymphocytes, 20 to 25% of the blood WBCs, lymphocytes. And these are, there are two major types. These are our lieutenant generals. If WBC are our army, these are our lieutenant generals. What are those? B cells and T cells. Bone marrow cells and B for bone marrow, yes. Two major types, B and T forms, responsible for immune responses of the body. So one is the B cells and T cells are most important. As I said there, if we consider WBC as army, the B cells and T cells are our lieutenant generals. And platelets are also called thrombocytes. Okay, platelets, of course here, this is a WBC, we are going to the next one. That is the third type, RBC, WBC, and third one is the platelets. And these are called thrombocytes. Okay, before we go to that, I think there is something. Yeah, neutrophils are most abundant and basophils are least abundant WBCs. Monocytes and neutrophils are phagocytic cells, means they swallow, which destroy foreign organisms. So various shapes he has given: eosinophil, basophil, neutrophil, T lymphocytes, monocytes, and B lymphocytes. Okay, thymus, the B for bone marrow, T for thymus. Basophils secrete histamine, serotonin, and heparin. This again, neat exam question, that are involved in inflammatory reactions. Eosinophils resist infection and allergic reactions. B and T lymphocytes are responsible for our immune response of the body. That's why they are very, very important. Thrombocytes are platelets, just now we talked, are cell fragments produced from megakaryocytes in bone marrow. And how many platelets? 1,50,000 to 3,50,000 platelets are present in each ml of the blood. This is important. Each ml of the blood. Platelets are involved in clotting or coagulation of blood in case of injury. Suppose there is any injury due to accident and the blood starts oozing out. If platelets or thrombocytes are not in required number, the blood flow will not be stopped. Hence, blood, in order to clot, there must be thrombocytes. Again, other side of it, in some patients, the numbers will go heavily. They increase their numbers. Then what happens? The blood will start clotting inside the body. That's also dangerous. So the numbers, neither they should be high nor should be low. That's why thrombocytes play crucial role in us. And based on the antibody and antigen, we have got blood groups. And basically, there are four blood groups: blood group A, blood group B, blood group AB, and blood group O. And thanks to one gentleman called Landsteiner, Carl Landsteiner, reported A, B, O blood groups first time in human beings, which are determined by the gene I for isoagglutinin. So there are three allelic forms of that gene I. What are those allelic forms? IA, IB, and IO or I0, we say, of this gene. Proteins produced by IA and IB alleles are called A antigen and B antigen respectively. I think we will take a separate session for this, so that you need elaborate explanation for